based plant source. I am basically a biochemistry, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Biochemistry, Periyar University, India. I take this opportunity to present my part of the basic research work we are conducting in our lab. And my specialization is on that of medicinal plants. And we are working on the plant therapeutics and taking on the compound isolation partially and put it on to that of the clinical trials with that of animal study to just ascertain the efficiency of the plant, how far it has got the effectiveness later, it will need to be developed to that of the drug. Okay, this is our university situated in the Salem. Oh, God. Yeah, Tamil Nadu. Okay. Yes, nanotechnology is a promising field for generating new types of nanomaterials with biomedical applications, namely drug delivery in food industries, agriculture, textile industry, and water treatment. Nanoparticles of noble metals such as gold, silver, and platinum are widely applied in the products which come in direct contact with the human body. And so there is a growing need to develop eco-friendly products from these sources. The development of nanoparticles for the delivery of therapeutic agents has introduced new opportunities for the improvement of medical treatment. They exhibit completely new or improved properties based on specific characteristics such as size, distribution, morphology when compared to that of the bulk materials. Okay, these are some of the applications of nanotechnology. Nanotechnology finds applications in that of the optical engineering, then in the case of bioengineering, then it comes into that of medicine and wide applications in energy and also synthesis of new products. Okay, this is about nanomedicine. Nanostructured materials engineered with enzymes and the products of biotechnology, they find application in future. Highly sophisticated, medically programmable nanomachines and nanorobots are also developed. It repair, construction and control of human biological systems using devices built upon nanotechnology standards. Nanotechnology can be used in many fields of medicine, namely pharmacy, visualization, and cancer, and diagnosis and the surgery. Nanoparticles can be developed in that of the drug delivery based on three aspects: metal-based nanoparticles, that is lipid-based nanoparticles, polymer-based nanoparticles, and biological nanoparticles. And kidney is the main organ of detoxification to go for all the toxins to be removed on. Okay, slides. Kidney are essential to life, receiving and detoxifying about 1/5 of the blood output of the each heartbeat. And without working of kidney, the existence of human life is very difficult, only can go for few days. The kidney is a major target for exogenous toxicant chemicals, ranging from intentionally given drugs to toxicants in the foodstuffs and also the environmental pollutants. Since kidney is vulnerable to toxin, it excretes many drugs. It is routinely exposed to high concentrations of drug or their metabolites or sometimes both. The proximal renal tubule presents a large area for nephrotoxin binding and transport into renal epithelium. Reabsorption progressively increases the interstitial nephron concentrations, while the specific transport pathways in the kidney make the specific to that of the kidney toxicity. Nephron is the basic unit of the kidney which undergoes to that of the toxicity. And nephrotoxicity is one of the most common kidney problem and occurs when the body is exposed to the drug or the toxin and causes damage to the kidney. Nearly 2 lakh people dying of kidney disease every year in India. The need for the R is to have more and more kidney disease detection clinics and to take up steps to arrest the deaths due to kidney failure. Chronic renal injury can occur and can be induced by some medications leading to chronic tubular interstitial inflammations, papillary necrosis, or prolonged proteinuria. Fluoride is largely present in the earth and is essential trace element for human beings and animals with oral route along with the food and water. Fluoride is found in small quantities in almost all foodstuffs and enters into the human body and have demonstrated that fluoride problem. All the age groups in several countries have suffered from the severe fluorosis due to ingestion of sodium fluoride. Chronic fluoride intoxication is also an important widespread health problem. World Health Organization has established 1.5 milligram fluoride per liter of drinking water as a safe limit, where the average daily intake of fluoride by adults should not exceed 2 milligram per day. Mitochondria may be the major target for fluoride toxicity in several organs, but the role of kidney mitochondria is least known. Fluoride high concentrations in the world, that is mainly kidney fluorosis, happens to be more pronounced in India and Italy, dental fluorosis in USA, and skeletal fluorosis in China. Fluorosis is an irreversible disease. Approximately 66 million people in the 19 states in India are affected with fluorosis, though the consumption of fluoride over a long period of time affects the soft tissues like muscle, liver, kidney, gastrointestinal tract, and several other reproductive and endocrine organs by the property of simple diffusion, which is caused to impairment of the soft tissues. Overall, nearly 200 million people worldwide rely on water sources of this contaminated with high fluoride content. So, in order to justify the effectiveness of this, plant has been used as a source to go for the development of a nephroprotectant using this plant. The plant chosen for my study is called Canthium coromandelicum, which belongs to the family of Rubaceae, and the species coromandelicum, common English name is called Caris sedi or wild jasmine. This plant contains a wide range of pharmacological potential. It is used as that of an antibacterial, antifungal, then it is used as a wound healing, then it has got an in vivo, in vitro antioxidant property, and it has got that of the effectiveness to that of a hypocholesterol property, etc. And this is the deduced protocol for the synthesis of the plant as a source of green synthesis of the nano-based phytopotential of Canthium coromandelicum. Exactly, we have selected the plant and it has been... Extraction method with that of ethanol in the ratio 1:10 using the Soxhlet apparatus. Then this incubated the 88 milliliter of this 1 mL of AgNO3 with that of 12 milliliter of aqueous extract of CC, and the solution turns to brown, which is go for the synthesized one, and the green synthesized now extract is now subjected to GCMS analysis, and after the compound has been identified, we subjected to that of the in vivo study using the animal experimentation to support with that of the molecular docking analysis. And how we synthesize the silver nanoparticles. The present study, we have the synthesized nanoparticle using the aqueous leaf extract of CC, and the approach is said to be a cost-effective alternate to conventional method for assembling nanoparticles. Formation and stability of nanoparticle in aqueous colloidal solution are confirmed with that of using a UV spectral analysis. Absorption spectra of the phytonanoparticles formed has been an absorption peak specific at 420 nanometer, and the broadening of the peak indicated that the particles are poorly dispersed. The nanoparticles are generally characterized by their size, shape, surface area, and the dispersity. The homogeneity of the properties is important in many applications. The common techniques of characterizing the nanoparticles are as follows. This is by using the characterization followed by that of FTIR. Then we used its TEM, then SEM, and also dynamic light scattering to identify the effectiveness of the nanoparticles synthesized in CC. Okay, this is the next aspect of animal experimentation. First, we isolated the plant and we prepared a nanosynthesis plan. And this particular nanosynthesis is now we are going to that of the in vivo study to that of an animal grouping. And we are categorized nearly five groups. Group one served as the normal control. And group two, we had the nephrotoxicity induction, which is done through the oral administration of fluoride, which is served as a toxicant, 25 milligrams per kg of body weight, once a day for 4 weeks for all the groups except the control. Whereas group 3 and 4, treatment of AG-NPS with that of both, we are compared with the crude extract as well as the AG-NPS CC treated group. Dose level of this is to be 400 milligram per kg, and methanolic crude leaf extract of CC is said to be, in case of the methanolic extract is 400, in the nano-based is 40 milligram per kg, were administered orally once a day for another 4 weeks. Then group 5, which is served as a standard drug with silmarine, with 25 mg per kg of body weight administered orally once a day for another 4 weeks. All the experiments were carried out according to the guidelines of the committee for the purpose of control of supervision of experiments in animals, that is called CPC-SEA, and approved by the Institutional Animal Ethical Committee. At the end of the experimental period, the rats were sacrificed and they were went on to the cervical decapitation using the chloroform anesthesia. Then both the blood and the tissue samples were used to analyze the various biochemical and the histopathological studies. The marker enzyme activities and the total protein concentration in kidney as well as in the plasma. Marker enzymes are important biochemical tools for diagnosing damage to the internal organs. Determination of the activities of the aminotransferases that provides a valuable confirmatory or suggestive evidence for the damage to the internal organs. Under the state of stress, damage to the liver, kidney and other organs leads to the rupture of plasma membrane. Hence, the release of these enzymes is very important from that of the point of view. These enzymes may be liberated into the blood. Slides are not coming to me. Good. Effect of CCAGNPS and the crude extract on the levels of the biochemical markers, namely urea, creatine, gamma GT, and cathepsin, to the control and experimental rats. They showed that in that of the group 2, there is an elevated level, and on the treatment with that of the plant extract, both the nano synthesized plant extract and the crude, and along with the standard, they are in the restoration, which again potentiates is that it has got the nephroprotective effectiveness. And this is again further, the after the biochemical markers and the marker enzyme studies has been given on a positive indication, we went on to go for that of the histopathological study to confirm the effectiveness in vivo. And this gives the photographic picture on the normal renal corpuscles formed from that of the tufts of the glomerular capillaries surrounded by that of the Bowman space. Then in the case of figure 2, group 2, where it has been fluoride, it has been intoxicated animal showed glomerular space tubular degeneration, and there seems to be hemorrhage and tubular renal epithelial vascularization and atrophy and dilatation and congestion and the necrosis in the tissues. And the damaged tissues on treatment with that of the plant extract, both the nano treated and crude, they show the restoration. Fluoride plus that of the CCAGP and coronal group displaying the marked improvement in the renal histology, showing the normal glomerulus proximal tubule and distal convoluted tubule getting normalcy, which has also been supported with that of the standard silmarine. The same histopathological report has been given on. And we are made on to a venture to go for the molecular docking studies, that is to specify how it has got a bonding interactions. So just to get on to this, we worked with the molecular docking, which seems to be the most important frequently used method because of its ability to predict with a substantial degree of accuracy and confirmation of small molecular ligands within appropriate target binding site. The identification of the most likely binding conformations requires mainly two steps. One is the exploration of a large conformational space representing various potential binding modes. Second is that accurate prediction of the interaction energy associated with each of the predicted binding conformations. The two markers we have taken, one is the NF kappa B. This seems to be the kidney specific markers along with that of the cytochrome C. So the transcription factors evoke the widespread interest until now. In fact, the dysfunction of the NF kappa B is associated with many disease states such as atherosclerosis, asthma, arthritis, cancer, osteoporosis, and etc. As a matter of the fact that NF kappa B, which is belong to a family involved in the control of gene expression for a number of mammalian genes, such as those encoding for major histocompatibility complex, MSC proteins, interferons, and the growth factors. So the inhibition of the selectivity of this plant compounds, which has been exhibited strong and selective inhibition of cytochrome C and NF-kappa B expression activity, which has been investigated using this molecular docking approach. So in the GCMSM analysis, we have identified that on the plant encompasses 13 compounds has been identified. In this specifically, we see the compound diiodoacyl phthalate and also heptadecanoic acid. These two finds to be more specific in bringing about the binding efficacy to that of the normal standard silmarine. And these compounds are identified to be as a phytochemical components with the basis of a flavonoids group. So this is the docking post. We see that of the NFP kappa B is docked with that of the compound isolated from that of our plant, that is heptadecanoic ester. And next one is the cytochrome C docked with the same compound in case of the silmarine along with that of the next compound. To conclude, the diligent effort on green synthesis of CCAGNPs will certainly provide an effective platform for new drug elucidation and therapy in order to combat metal-induced kidney disease in the near future. The effectiveness and safety are the two prime criteria for any compounds to serve as a drug. So with this focus, we intended to take in the development of AGNPS-CC, which potentiated its phytochemical viability and also nephroprotective effect with a positive threshold on molecular study, thereby safeguarding the nephrotic tissue, which is clearly exhibited by the histological studies. So in future, Canthium coromandelicum validates the nephroprotective effect and will also certainly provide an insight for the new drug discovery and also for therapy. Thank you.